Hello there, Coriolanus, the hero without a country. Starting on 493 BC, I decide to conquer the whole world and win the battle against him.
The Romans celebrated Caesar's victory with a huge feast that went on for hours and hours.
We are going to swing in a major way, baby.
Relax, everybody! Look what Frogo made! And get a load of these handlebar grips!
The best way to protect your land is with a totally dense castle.
Rock solid!
Going to Rome, from his home, across the sea, or through the snow. He can't decide yet which way's the best bet to get to Rome, from his home.
Didn't I just say that?
How about back there? Guess what? More water! Yesterday, water! The day before, water! For the past 70 days, water! Nothing but water!
Friends, are you tired of the everyday boredom of life in first century Rome?
Yes!
Then you need a vacation home at the foot of majestic Mount Vesuvius in beautiful Pompeii. Say goodbye to the traditional Japanese armor made from lacquered leather and silk. And say hello to improved steel armor, offering resistance to even the most stubborn ammunition.
Who wants water?
A brilliant military leader, Caesar was appointed perpetual dictator of Rome.
Sorry, doll. Pickings were slim, and the network sent a big youth kick.
There it is! That's the signal!
Follow that dome.
Yeah, like all the way to Berlin, dudes.
And so the film director Giorgio Villani has directed the new film, The Thunder of Battle.
And now, an eyewitness to history news brief.
The year is 41 BC. The great Roman general Mark Antony journeys to Alexandria to seek financing for his troops.
Hi, Dick! I just love you! I just love everyone!
Oh, I'm right here, Your Honor, dude. Sorry I'm late and stuff.
But thanks to the help of a faithful servant, she was able to arrange a private meeting with Caesar and plead her case.
Caesar, a gift from Her Majesty.
Recollect! I hate the part about that stupid curse!
I'm not happy.
This is bad, all right.
No, no, no. This is a disaster.
Hear ye, hear ye. Today is the Ides of March, March 15th. It is foretold on this day
that the emperor must die.
Who foretold that?
Me.
And who are you?
The assistant emperor.
Really?
Yeah, the situation stinks!
Uncle Poop! Boogie! Poop!
Hey, you! You find this thing painted on the pyramid walls!
Oh, yeah, well, you know, I just remembered something. Help!
But alas, it was not to last.
Prepare for all of my exams.
See? I'm a huge hit with the kids.
Okay, that's it. You people have gone way overboard this time. I'm officially shutting down this sketch immediately.
I did what I could.
I, Nostradamus, predict Joan of Arc will be burned at the stake.
I was right!
Is there any more extra crispy? Uh-oh! Chicken bone!
Unfortunately, the Heimlich maneuver had not yet been invented. And so Cleopatra, the great and beautiful queen of the Nile, was finally at peace.
Haters went wild. They had these cheese puffs that were out of this world. But it didn't last long.
The marriage?
No, the cheese puffs, they ran out.
But
What about the marriage?
Oh, a disaster. It went bust, but I got married again. This time to my other brother.
On December 26, 1606, in England, William Shakespeare had published the first performance of King Lear. That is me. I am so bored. I wish I had entertained. Where is my beautiful girl?
I also wrote the plays Hamlet, Macbeth, Romeo and Juliet, and Othello. Those all had sad endings.
An indulgence means paying money to be released from sin.
I am a little girl only 11 years old, but want you should be very much. So I hope you won't think me very bold. All the ladies like whiskers, and they would tease their husbands to vote for you. Well, the next thing I know, and they put his picture in the paper.
But anyways, I guess I didn't do too bad, because now I'm like a patron saint of France.
Ooh!
But like in heaven, you get to wear whatever you like, and like no one gives you a hard time.
The beard was pretty cool, right, Abe? Trying some new threads.
I wanna know what was happening to me. Everyone was excited about me.
Oh, it is so you! Honest Abe!
And now, the Warner Brothers, in a scene from William Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream, translated for those viewers who, like Yakko, have no idea what he's saying.
Hey, Mr. Gutenberg, do you have a bottle of glue and some tadpoles? You can read about it in my new book, 101 Uses for Glue and Tadpoles.
Adventure packed with thrills, intrigue, and plenty of suspense.
If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended.
If the actors in our show made you mad, it'll be okay if you look at it this way.
That you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear.
You fell asleep on your butt and dreamed the whole thing.
Greetings, Cassius.
Hail Decimus, hail Trebonius, hail Bacillus, hail Tilius.
Where is Brutus?
At Neiman Marcus.
What news, Brutus?
Hail Tilius, hail Trebonius, hail Fungus, hail Mucus, hail Felonius, hail Lexus.
And this weak and idle theme. No more yielding, but a dream.
There is a hole in the plot you could drive a truck through.
Gentles, do not reprehend.
Honeys, don't blame us. You could be watching Oprah.
So the next time Mary's little lamb comes walking down the way, admire its fleece as white as snow and not its DNA.
On holidays, King Romulus would like throw really cool banquets and would invite his entire family to join him in the festivities.
If we have unearned luck now to escape the serpent's tongue,
what he said,
we will make amends ere long.
We'll buy you footlong hot dogs.
Else the puck a liar call. So, good night unto you all.
Good night, everybody!
Hello, nurse!
And now, our bonus presentation.
In the 80s, there was Cold War drama. We fought the commies inside Nicaragua. Our friends were the Contras. Freedom was their mantra, so we sent them lots of money for guns and landmines. But Congress stopped the Contra money flow just cause they moved a teeny bit of blow. But then a hero came forth. His name was Oliver North. He and Reagan went around the sissy Congress. Holly North! See, North secretly sold missiles to a harmless country called Iran, would always be a grateful ally. Then he gave the profits to the Contras. Genius! But the sales were uncovered by the press. Reagan and North began to stress. Because what they did was technically high treason. But it was totally justified. North volunteered to take the blame to save Reagan from
preparation. You are such
but
a grouch!
He did marry with his hot secretary, thanks to her shredder. He got a totally scot-free. Oh, enough! Oh, enough! He's a
soldier
and relaxation
and a hero and a novelist, and now he's on Fox News.
Oh, darn, that is the end.
Well, we all loved the Shepherd drawings when we started on the picture, and still do. But you can't take something like that that is drawn only in certain views. We have to be able to draw the character in every position, every view.
And he wanted to be sure that we captured the story, that we captured a strength in the characters so that they would exist on their own. They didn't rely on you having read the story.
Joyfully now to our princess we come.